Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us on Citizen Live at 1. I am Terri-Ann Chibet. Now we kick off with a probe into the illegal allocation of 500,000 acres in Lamu, which has just kicked off at the Kenyatta International Conference Center. And we now go live there, where our reporter Alex Kubasu will join us live. Alex, good afternoon. Just do tell us, first of all, how have the events unfolded this morning?
Yes, good afternoon indeed, Terri-Ann Chibet. You are live at the Kenyatta International Conference Center, where the National Land Commission, that is constitutionally mandated to manage public land on behalf of both the county and the national government, has started the effecting of the presidential directive on the 31st of July this year that directed the National Land Commission to investigate the allocation of close to 500,000 acres in Lamu County. And today the investigations by the National Land Commission have started, and I'm now joined by the chairman of the National Land Commission, Dr. Mohammed Swazuri, to just give us the details of what the early morning investigations have yielded. Karibu sana, daktari. So far, how many allottees have you investigated, and what is the progress of your grilling?
Today we started the investigation. As I've said, we have so far interviewed three of the representatives of the allottees. None of the allottees has shown up. We only interviewed the representatives, one for a company called Brick Investments, the other for Ruskin International, and the third one was for MAT International. So the first one just clarified that their client did not own any land in that area. The second one, we had a full hearing for them. This is Mr. Ruskin International, who actually purchased the land from another, who sold the land to another person, but the lawyers represented all the current owner, who is Kalyon Limited. The third person came, but he asked for time so that he can represent on 28th of this month. So he has got four properties. He's representing owners of four properties who we shall hear on 28th of this month, all the four. So this afternoon we are going to have one person representing MAT International who will give their presentations.
So I can see you're joined by your fellow commissions, and just a sneak peek of what is coming out from the grilling that has gone on for close to 4 hours right now.
Well, what is coming out is that today, you know, it is an information gathering from us. It's the first stage that we have in the investigations. So we already have information. We are asking for information from them so that we can collaborate that information. Then in the next stage, after investigating if there are any anomalies, is when we shall call them to come and cross-examine. But what is happening, what we have seen from today is that the parcels are quite large. All of the four that we have seen are quite large, 40,000 acres, and the owners don't seem to know whether there are people who have encroached on those parcels or not. They don't seem to know. None of them has been developed so far. They are still vacant parcels, and people have charged those properties for colossal sums of money. And I think we are yet to look at the information they have given us to find out if there are any mistakes in them.
So I sat through the grilling, and most of your commissioners were really on the cases of the allottees on the usage of that land. What role does this usage really paint in as far as the allocation is concerned?
You know, land is not required for its sake. Land is required for a purpose. Even when you apply to the government to get land, you also state the purpose for which you want that land. And when you are given that land, there are conditions in the lease which tell you what to use with that that land. So our interest with finding out the use of land is whether these people have complied with the conditions connections or they have not. And it, when you go to that, you'll find out whether it is bought for actual use or is bought for speculative purposes.
Thank you so much, Chairman and the Commissioners. Terry-Ann, the sessions will continue this afternoon where Ruskin Limited is expected to front either the legal representatives or the allottees themselves. So we shall be able to keep our viewers updated on our Twitter handle on what is happening here at the KICC. And back to you, Terry-Ann.
Alex Kubasa, thank you so much for that. Now, three people have been killed by lightning in Masabo Village, Kiamokama Division in Kisii County. The three were killed while working on a farm in the area. Masabo South OCPD Martha Ngetich confirmed the incident, saying the dead included two women and a Standard 8 pupil. The Standard 8 pupil was set to sit for her KCPE at the end of the year.
A somber mood engulfed Masabo Village, Kiamokama Division in Kisii County. The facial expressions of these residents clearly depicting that all is not well here. Perhaps they had lost their loved ones under this avocado tree located in the middle of this shamba, a death the three met after suffering burns when lightning struck them while under this tree on Tuesday afternoon.
Walikuwa this side, na hili mtoto alikuwa that side, hamechomega kifua na hapa mapacha. Lakini hawa mama walichomega kifua, moja nguo zimeisha, hata hapa kwa kifua hamechomega, paka amekuwa hamechange color, amekuwa red.
Among the deceased was a class 8 KCPE student at Chirongo Primary School. Her dreams were shattered by this unexpected demise. Teachers, parents and fellow pupils converged here to mourn the departed loved one.
This candidate was a good girl in class, who was doing her work diligently, and she was so much obedient. As a staff and a community of the school, we are so much shocked on that.
Masaba South OCPD Martha Ngetich confirmed the incident as residents urged the government to erect lightning arresters to avert more calamities. The bodies were taken to Gucha Sub-District Hospital in Keroka, while the fourth survivor is recuperating at the Masaba District Hospital.
Now, bomb experts have detonated four old landmines that were found in a village in Wajir County. The landmines were found by pastoralists who were herding animals and are suspected to have been left behind during the Second World War.
The old landmines were found in different locations in Abak Matobe village by some residents who were herding animals in the area. The locals raised the alarm by informing the area chief, who responded immediately by informing the security agency. Bomb experts and security officers soon arrived at the scene and detonated the old explosive. Residents here have been living in fear after some of them were crippled by similar explosives in the past.
We have already destroyed them and we have urged the chief to go further and find out if there is any, so that we make the area safe for the locals. The military officers, we don't know. It might be either the Italians, because this explosive has overstayed in the ground.
Speaking to Citizen TV, Wajir County Commissioner David Kirui also urged the locals to provide police with information on any suspicious object. Morgan Mweke, Citizen, live at 1.
Residents of Muyeye village in Malindi have been severely affected by jigga infestation, which they say has affected their everyday life. But there is hope in the horizon for the residents after an organization offered free treatment to many of the affected. Hassan Farah has the details.
Poor housing and sanitation have been known for many years to be leading contributors to the fast breeding of jiggas in many areas. And these dilapidated houses in Muyeye village in Malindi, Kilifi County, point to exactly why residents here are struggling to cope with jiggas infestation.
Funza amekuwa ni chanzo chenye ameingia ndani, paka tunapata watoto wengi, afya ya mtoto inadhoofika, maisha ya mtoto pia, maerimu, hana.
But the many years of suffering have in a flash been turned to moments of comfort after well wishes from the Huduma Youth Organization came to the rescue of the Jigas infested residents of Muyeye village.
The area kwa hakika imeathirika sana. Imeathirika na wadudu wa aina ya funza, imeathirika na wadudu wa aina ya bedbugs ambao ni kunguni. Kuna cockroaches wingi sana area za huku, na watu wa huku wanahitaji wasaidike kwa njia ya madawa na vitu vingine vya kusaidia kama kufanya usafi vile, kuimarisha hali yao ya usafi na hali yao ya kiafya.
Speaking during a free Jigas treatment exercise, the area chief Nicodemus Monyele revealed that over 45% of the residents have been affected by the problem. He attributed the prevalence of Jigas infestation to poor hygiene standards and high poverty levels in the area.
Funza sababu yake kubwa inaletwa na uchafu. Na tukiwa na uchafu, sisi kama wananchi, ni kwamba hata serikali ikifanya nini, wale mafunza hawezi kuondoka. Kwa hivyo, labda ningewapatia changamoto wananchi pia. Kama serikali tutasaidia upande wetu, na upande wa wananchi pia nao wakisawasawa.
Jigas infestation continues to pose a major challenge in many rural areas, as well as informal settlements in urban centers. Hassan Farah, Citizen Live at 1.
Two Kiambu County legislators are now calling on the County Senator Kimani Wamatange to urgently convene the County's Development Board in order to avoid a duplication of development projects in the county. Limuru Member of Parliament John Kiragu and his Kabete counterpart George Moshai say the County Development Board would not only ensure that county development projects are synchronized, but would also protect the implementation of the projects from corruption.
Tukiwachiliwa hivyo hatutaongea sisi kwa sisi. Eh? Unakuta mtu anataka kujenga ile barabara, mtu mwingine anataka kujenga. Ukitaka kutengeneza shule, unaona county naye anataka kutengeneza shule, mbunge naye ameleta pesa yake ya CDF hapo.
Wanatuma auditors kule, auditors wanakuta mradi umefanywa lakini haukufanywa na pesa za county. Alafu zile pesa mamilioni ziibiwe.
Well, Citizen Live at 1 takes a short break. Now we'll be back with more after the break. Don't go too far.